the compliment?
Yes, we are getting great response from people, and the comments are just overwhelming at times. Honestly, I did not think, I knew that it is going to connect with people, but I didn't know that this is the kind of comments people are going to write. It's really heart touching to see people are writing that, you know, thank you Shama ma'am for making this show, because of you I didn't give up. I think that's the biggest victory for me. That's why I made this, and if that is happening, then my job is done. Itne sare comments hai, like they all actually bring tears in my eyes, because I made this with so much heart, and if it's touching their heart, like there's nothing better for me. That's the biggest gift they can give me. And so I want to thank you all for watching and writing those comments, because when you write that, I come to know whether you're liking it or not liking it, or what you're liking and what you're not liking. You know, expression is also a way of getting away from depression. When you express, you stay away from all these you know, illnesses or problems in your life, because then you are clear. So thank you for being expressive, and thank you for writing all those beautiful comments.
Okay, in the fifth chapter, Gaurav Chopra will be seen. So how was your experience with Gaurav, sir?
Gaurav has been my friend for a long time. I've known him. We were neighbors. We used to live in Malad together, and first I used to think he's a very snobbish guy. I used to think, like, you know, he doesn't talk to anybody because he comes across as like, wow, what, you know. But the moment I spoke to him for the first time, we met in a party, and, you know, he came across as a very, very simple, sweet gentleman. And I was like, are, you know, I had this wrong perception of a guy, and how silly of me to even think like that, because without even talking to him, I just made this judgment just by looking at him that he's a snob. But he's not. And that taught me something in life. Gaurav has been my friend since then. We've had such great conversations together. Long conversations, spiritual conversations, rubbish conversations. Like, we've just had fun. And nobody would ever try to, you know, please each other. Or nobody ever tried to sort of... our friendship was just... It was just effortless. And when I thought of acceptance, I wanted a friend who can understand me and my process, who knows me. And also, you know, it's just one day shoot. In this series, we've shown that the girl and the boy has been dating for a long time, and now it's time for them to take the relationship forward. So I wanted something who knows me from before. Aisa koi nahi ho ki, you know, aaj aaya hai and aaj to figure out kar raha hai ki kya ho raha hai, kya nahi ho raha hai. So I wanted somebody who I know from before, and Gaurav is... Gaurav was the only one who I could think of, and he matches my persona also. So I needed somebody who's a little who compliments me on screen. So that's how Gaurav's name came, and he was very sweet. Instantly, you know, it came, and I just called him, and he was ready. In 5 minutes, he said, "You don't have to tell me anything. Just tell me where to come." So that's very, very sweet of him to do. To trust another actor who's also a producer of the show, to trust the other person, you know, to handle you, knowing that, you know, it's her idea, it's her thought, and she's the heroine of the whole thing. It was very sweet of him. He came with a very surrendering attitude of a friend, which I just loved. Yeah.
Okay, the fifth chapter is streaming on 3rd August. So is it particularly your thought, because it's your birthday on 4th? Any specific reason?
No, yeah, Friday just ended up just before my birthday. So, aisa koi thought nahi tha. I wanted acceptance to come a little later, when people are used to Abdul Ki Sunn and they know what we are trying to say, because acceptance is a smallest film, probably one of the shortest, but it raises a very big question. It raises a question where, you know, which is lacking. Not only today, but it has been lacking since forever, and it's high time that we think about it. And I have gone through it in my life, and I have thought about it, and only by accepting it, I became a better person. So it is about truth. You know, we expect everybody else to speak the truth, but are we ready to listen to the truth? Are we ready to accept it? Are we ready to understand it? That's what acceptance is all about. So yeah, it's a short film, but it raises a very big question, so I wanted it to come a little later, so it just ended up just before my birthday.
Okay, Dil Ke Sunn is mainly basically deal with depression or bipolar disorder. So any message you'd like to give to the audience or to the viewers who deal with the depression?
You know, it doesn't only deals with depression or bipolar, it deals with humanity today. Everything that happens, even depression that is happening in the world, why is it happening? Because there are certain problems with human nature that we need to correct, and because of those problems, these kind of things exist, like depression or bipolar. What are these? These are just fluctuations in your brain. And why do they happen? Because your body or your brain cannot take a particular kind of stress that has been given to you by your family, or it could be your friends, or it could be the society, it could be people around you. We have a habit of judging everybody in one way, but each person is different, and each person is made different. They think differently, they have different wavelengths, different capacity to understand or to accept a joke or no. So one must understand, we end up hurting unaware, in an unaware status, we end up hurting each other so much that it creates something like depression or a bipolar disorder. It can take you to that level. Now we would say, "Arey kya itna simple to tha yaar, kya maine aisa kuch bol diya?" But simple cheeze hi bahut badi dukhdayak hoti hain. Simple cheeze hi aapko sabse zyada dukh pahunchati hain life mein. So you have to understand. So I wanted to highlight those simple things in Ab Dil Ki Sunn, and so those are not just about depression and bipolar. These things are about humanity and human nature, and being conscious and being aware in what we do to each other.
Okay, last two questions. Ab Dil Ki Sunn is the first venture of your home production. So which part you enjoyed the most as a producer or as an actor?
That's a difficult question. Well, I always love being an actor. I think that comes naturally. First, I'm an actor. I became a producer because I know the craft, and I know a lot of people. I know a lot of technicians who are fantastic in their craft, and I am a very creative person. I like to make things, you know. Even when I'm acting, I'm making a character, you know, which has been written. I'm actually putting life in it. So I like doing that. I think all humans, we all like doing that. That's why we give birth to another being, because we like to create. That's why I became a producer, because when I came to the industry, I always wanted to be to have my own production house, because I used to get very angry and upset when people used to treat newcomers badly, and I used to say one day I'll have my own production house in that zone, you know. And today I have it, and I'm grateful for it, and I just feel blessed that I have it today, and I really want to make some films that can bring some kind of change in the mentality of people, because I feel that films have such a huge so much power. It can change, and because it can change in abundance, because it goes to so many people, and you know, they watch it. Oftentimes it's just the small things that changes our mentality. Kisi ne kuch baat kahi aur wo hume lag gayi aur wo hume change karta hai. So when you see it in a, you know, as a film or as a short film or as a TV show, whatever, in a film format, you are so quiet when you're watching it. Your brain is quiet. It's not giving you logics, or it's not making you think kya bakwas hai kya nahi hai. First you're watching it, and by watching it you're absorbing it quietly. You are not talking when the film is being played, you know. So jab aap silence mein kuch sunte hain, to ye it absorbs better, so people understand that better, you know. So that's why I wanted to spread awareness about depression or whatever in a film format, so that people can understand it better.
Okay, finally, the fifth chapter is streaming on 3rd August. So what do you like to say to the viewers, your fans?
I just want to say that whatever love you've given to us till now, you need to give more love. I want everything from you. I'm very greedy when it comes to love. So if you really want that this kind of project or these kind of films should be you know, made more often, then you need to show love and you need to make them big, because only you can make them big. We can only make it, but your viewership, your numbers, because everything is about number in this world, unfortunately, your numbers will make sure, will make other people realize, the finances, the producers realize that, oh, public really likes this, they want this kind of project, and then you will get these kind of projects more often. Because what happens is, if, when we go as an audience, we go and watch something crap, then only crap will be made for you. If you want something better in your life, then you must give importance to that better in your life as much as you give all the other, you know, bad things. So do watch Abdul Ki Sunn, chapter 5th, acceptance, this Friday 3 p.m. on YouTube, Shama Sikander Films, and don't forget to press the bell icon and do subscribe.
Thank you, ma'am.